We're not going to let one game steal the joy and the memories that we made this year. Hear me? This is a great football team. This is a great football team. That football team over there is probably going to win the national championship. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. Do you hear me? I am so proud of the men in this brotherhood. You took a step this year that no Bison football team has ever taken. And it was because of you. Because of your love for each other. Because of your hard work. Because of your leadership all year long. This has been and is a blessed brotherhood.
Yes, sir.
Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
There's nothing like it. Nothing like it. I love you guys. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud to be able to say that I am your coach. And this, to say that this was my last football team to Hardy, nothing means more to me than this. You hear me?
Yes, sir.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to the final edition of Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. And, Coach, what a tremendous speech right there. And you summed up 2016, 13-1 for the Bisons and the brotherhood. There is nothing like it.
This year, Billy, what an unbelievable experience for me, for our coaches, for our players, hopefully for our fans. All that we were able to share this year, the joy that we were able to bring to Harding football and all the people that are involved in our constituency. It was just a wonderful blessing. I have continued to say to Peggy all year long, I cannot believe how blessed we are to be a part of this program and to be able to finish out this way. And it's just been unbelievable.
We saw the tremendous support, the Bison fans that were there in Northwest Missouri on the final game. And because of all these firsts, Coach, it was a tremendous year. And just talk about these accolades.
Well, we did have a lot of individual recognition, and you have individual recognition when your team does well. And I think that's what we take away from it, is that the combination of all the things that we were able to do as a football team, on the field, off the field, culminated in this type of recognition for our team. And I'm so proud of our individual players that were able to accomplish this, but every one of them, I promise you, would say, if you asked them, they would say, it was because of my brothers that I played with every week, and because of the things that they did, allowed me to make some plays, and that's really special.
So we have a big show for you, and it'll be fun to look back. We have the highlights from Central Missouri and also the highlights from Sioux Falls and Northwest Missouri State. And we'll start right after this with Central Missouri first half highlights.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba, the postseason edition. And we'll start with highlights with Central Missouri. It was number 20 Central Missouri coming to town against number 5 Harding. And we knew this was a good football team coming in, and we saw it early.
Without a doubt. The MIA this year was Northwest Missouri pretty much by themselves at the top. And then right beneath them, you had two teams. You had Central Missouri and Emporia State that both had great years. Central Missouri was the third seed out of that conference, but an outstanding football team, and they showed it on that first drive by just taking the ball down and scoring against our defense. Fortunately, we were able to match that, and it was a back-and-forth game for a good portion of the game, and we were able to take control in the fourth quarter. This was a fast screen to Andrew Dather, who had a fantastic game against Central Missouri. And then we were able to get the option pitch. That's to Zach Shelley. Park does a great job of reading it. And Zach gets down inside the 5-yard line. Great blocking out in front of Zach. And we hand the ball off on the belly trap to Michael Latu, and he's in the end zone. And we tie the score up at 7-7.
Big drive there. 10 plays, 68 yards to match the opening drive from
Central Missouri. That was really important that we answered in that situation, because we knew these guys had a very dynamic offense. There's Trayvon and Deontay with pressure on the quarterback, and Trayvon gets a sack. There's another situation where we're able to put pressure on the quarterback. He escapes and gets outside the pocket, dumps the ball off, and they score and again go up ahead of us by one touchdown.
Yeah, 14-7 at this point. Here come the Bisons right back.
And we were able to get our perimeter option game going in a big way against Central Missouri, and it was good for us the entire game. Play action right there to Andrew. And, you know, this was one of our most effective games that we've had in the last several years, throwing the football. And it was because of the way they were deployed defensively, we were able to get a lot going. This is a toss to Eric Simmons, who probably had his best game as a Bison against Central Missouri. And he's able to twist and get in the end zone and tie it up. And now it's 14-all.
Another important drive, 11 plays, 70 yards on that drive that took 6.5 off the clock.
This was huge right there. That's a play by Isaiah Jefferson in the end zone to stop that pass, and we force him to kick a field goal. And that allows us to score and go ahead. That's Davis Holloman with the catch on the boot pass. And there's Park with the second phase of the option. And makes a good gain. Park again, and he breaks a tackle, and man, Park had such a tremendous game against these guys running the football. It was a huge part of our success offensively. There's the handoff to Michael Attu on the first phase of the option, and Michael makes a great gain. There's the midline again, and that, you know, that play has been such a successful play for us all year long. Hands the ball off again to Michael, and he breaks outside and for another really good game. Midline option for a touchdown. That's Park. Great blocking up front by our offensive line and our slots.
And the first lead for the day for the Bisons right here, 21-17.
This was a tough break for us. That ball started tailing back away from Frank, and he kind of lost it a little bit. They recovered it. And, you know, we go from getting our first lead and having a chance to extend that to giving them the momentum. And their quarterback was such a good football player. He put that ball right on the money. They go up.
Yeah, 24-21, Coach. And I think what may be set up, maybe the biggest play of the season right
without
here.
Without a doubt. As far as regaining the momentum, this was beautiful. Look at that block right there by Christian Witt. And Corey hits the sideline, and of course, he has tremendous speed, and he's able to take that thing all the way into the end zone, and just like that, we have regained the momentum, and we go up 28-24.
93 yards, Corey Bassett. And then Corey Bassett blocks the field goal at the end of the half.
Corey finished that half of football in a great way with two giant special teams plays. And, you know, that took us into the halftime with a great lead.
And it had to be a good feeling going into the half because you had seemed to have the momentum before the fumble, and then they score, and then you grabbed it right back. That's team did all year.
They did. That's exactly what they did. I think that's indicative of the way we played all year long. And, you know, first half, those two big special teams plays right there at the end of the first half. We went into the halftime with a lot of confidence. You know, we knew we were going to get the ball first. And they hadn't really stopped us on offense, so we were ready to go.
So the Bisons with the lead at the half in the Central Missouri game. Stay with us. We'll come back and look at what's a very exciting second half.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba, postseason edition. Let's look now at the second half of the Central Missouri game. We go to the third quarter. Bison's up 28-24 at this point. Central Missouri are going to come right back at the Bison's here in the third quarter.
This was great pursuit and a really hard tackle by our defense. It's kind of rattled their quarterback a little bit. Of course, he came back and made a beautiful throw, and they went ahead, and that was their last lead of football game.
Good catch there by Kyle Echols, too, to bring it in.
Right.
A little bit behind him.
We were able to do a great job with our passing game, as we mentioned earlier. That's Park throwing to Andrew Dather on the corner route. And we come back and run the counter play to Eric Simmons. And he hit a little crease right there and then was, as we said, Eric had such a great day. And this is another play by Eric Simmons on the toss. He gets into the end zone with great blocking out in front of him. And we retake the lead, and that was the last time Central Missouri had a lead. Again, what a beautiful pass by Park to Eric Kelly. That's on the play action pass. And then we come back and run the midline option. And I believe that was a 41-yard dash by Park into the end zone. And boy, that was pretty. That put us up by 10.
And at the first really moment of the game, I kind of breathed a little bit, I think, at that point.
I think most of us did. Great pressure by our defensive line. We sack him, cause a fumble. That's Trayvon with the sack. I think Dalen Skidmore recovered that fumble.
Yeah.
And, from that point forward, we had pretty much control of the football game.
And then you mentioned the passing, obviously 149 yards
right.
for Andrew Dather alone
right.
On the receiving end of that. Park Parrish had a huge day, 118 yards rushing, and he threw for 173 yards.
And I think he was like 6 out of 7?
Six of seven, threw for a touchdown and ran for 2 touchdowns.
Right. Big day by Park. Big
sure
day
was.
By our offense. It was very important, as dynamic as that football team was offensively, that we were able to match their scoring. And I think because we were able to match it, it gave our defense some confidence. And in the second half, we played tremendous on defense.
The crowd was great. It wasn't the largest crowd ever at First Security Stadium, but it may have been the most vocal and as far as really into the football game. And
no
I think
doubt.
They were a difference maker.
There's no doubt about it, Billy. We were really worried about that because all the students were going to be gone. And, several of our administrators, including Dr. McLarty, made a pitch to the community, come out and support us. Mm-hmm. And they did, and they did it in a great way. They were very engaged the entire ball game. We could feel the energy mm-hmm. behind us. And I think that was a big part in us being able to come out on top of that football game. And as I said a while ago, defensively, we held them to 92 yards in the mm-hmm. second half. Against a football team that was that explosive. That was a tremendous stat.
And after the game, we're going to have a chance to hear from Dalen Skidmore and Park Parrish.
A lot of persistence in the second half. You know, we kept persisting the whole game. It wasn't really working out well for us at first. Coach Simmons made some great play calls and put me in the right position to make some plays. And our defensive line is so dominant that, you know, they're too worried about blocking those four guys that linebackers typically come pretty free. So, Coach Simmons did a great job calling those plays.
All started up front. You know, I had plenty of time. There's nobody in my face. Andrew, stuck on the corner route and had that corner turn in circles, and he was wide open down the middle. My part was easy. Just get him the ball. He was the one who made the play. It was awesome. I mean, you just really could tell that was the turning point of the game.
It looked like he was in both hands,
man. Yeah, that was different scenes. But,
it's funny. Number 18, Andrew Dather for the touchdown.
One yard.
Right.
And from Park Parrish.
Yeah, we had the ball on our own 19-yard line, and I think that was for sure the dagger. You could kind of see out there on the field the air went out of their balloon big time, and we got so much energy on our sideline from that play. And we're able to go ahead and finish the game out in a great way and get our first playoff victory.
Couple of warriors we saw right there, Dalen Skidmore, Park Parrish. I think that's the best way to describe those guys, and great people.
Great people, and if you ask them, I know that Park and Dalen both have been asked this in interview situations about, man, you guys are warriors, and they'd say, Coach, we got a team full of warriors.
That's right.
And we do, for sure. And that's one of the reasons we were 13-1 this year.
So the Bisons with a win over Central Missouri, 48-31, and then up next it would be a trip up to Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and we'll look at the first half highlights of that game right after this.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. The Bisons' next trip would be up to Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Charter flight up to Sioux Falls, and I know that was a great trip for the kids, and to get a win was even better.
Great trip for our football team, and you know, we got to spend the week of Thanksgiving together.
Right.
We had some real highlights during the course of that week. You know, we had our moms fed us Thanksgiving dinner on Tuesday night,
and
so it was an awesome, awesome week.
And we knew what an explosive Sioux Falls team you're going to see. The defense, obviously, Cordell Zielinski, great play right there, but they started with a big kick return that got them in good field position.
Right. Very well coached football team. Very, very strong football team on both sides of the ball. Good special teams, just a well-coached team. Long trip for us, yeah. And you always worry about that, and they were able to start with a field goal. But that
did
was
you feel a, like that was a win, though?
I felt like that was a win, for sure. And, you know, we got the option game going pretty quick against these guys, and felt like from the opening play that we were going to be able to move the football against them, and that turned out to be true. That's Zach Shelley on the option pitch, and, of course, Zach had a tremendous year for us. And there's Park on the midline. Gets the ball down inside the 25. This was a bad omen right there as far as us taking care of the football like we wanted to in that football game. We felt like if we had done a better job of taking care of the ball, we could have controlled the game earlier. But it is what it is, and we were able to bounce back and still get a good drive going. This is a trap play to Dwayne Carter. For a good gain, and that play was real good to us in this ball game. We come back running again, and you can see the hole and the blocking out in front of Dwayne. He's doing a great job of double covering the ball and securing it. So it takes us pretty much to the second quarter before we get on the board for the first time. But our defense was playing so well that we were able to hang in there with them.
Yeah, still just 3-0 right now. Sioux Falls with the advantage early in the second quarter.
There's the counter play to Brandon Gates. Brandon's keeping his legs moving and doing a great job of getting the ball inside the 15-yard line. Hands the ball off to Dwayne Carter on the first phase of the option. And he's got that ball down really close to the 1-yard line. And we run the quarterback ISO, and Park walks into the end zone. And so, great drive by our offense.
Bisons with their first advantage, 7-3. That was a 92-yard drive.
Yeah, that's exactly what we needed to happen. We need to keep our defense off the field and maintain possession and end in a score. And we were able to do that. There's another, Park forced that one a little bit high, and we weren't able to handle it. We were moving the ball at that point. At this point, they had not stopped us. We had just stopped ourselves twice. Can't do that against a good football team, but boy, what a great job by our defense and the super blitz by Daylon Skidmore. A lot of pressure on the quarterback, and they're able to run the quarterback read play off of the speed sweep. And get in the end zone, and now they retake the lead.
Very good quarterback, obviously, you're facing there in Luke Papillion.
Right. One of the top D2 quarterbacks in the country, without a doubt. We get the option going again and convert into a first down. And again, like I said, we're moving the football and doing a great job of it. There's Grant Kimberlin. The turf monster gets him. You can see he was frustrated with that. We come back and throw the deep ball to Andrew, and he has such tremendous ball skills and ability to judge the ball in the air. We get the ball inside the 10. Come on, we run that's the midline double. We got the ball down to about the 3-yard line. And this was a huge play right here. Park is able to scramble and find Luke Bowser in the end zone for a touchdown. Luke's a redshirt freshman tight end for us that's done a great job for us all year long.
And that was on third down, and to close out, once again, to close out a half with the momentum right. going into the halftime.
Right. You know, to be ahead of those guys 14-10, considering the fact that we had two, you know, bad turnovers, I felt great about it. And I knew we were going to do a better job of taking care of the football in the second half.
So the Bisons with the advantage at half, 14-10 at Sioux Falls. We'll take a timeout, come back, and look at the second half highlights in a moment.
If you don't fix them, sparks from dragging tow chains could cause a wildfire, and that could be scary.
Ah, Smokey!
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. The Bisons with a 14-10 lead at the half at Sioux Falls as we get ready to look at the third quarter highlights. And what an exciting second half that would not be finished just in the second half. We would go to overtime.
Without a doubt, you know, these guys were able to recapture the momentum and they came back out with a little bit different plan defensively and were able to get some stops against our offense, which, you know, we felt like we had not been stopped in the first half. We're still moving the football and doing some things, but we weren't able to sustain a drive. But, man, our defense just continued to play great. They had done that the whole day. A couple of times we thought we'd strip the ball out and we ended up not getting the call. But, you know, that running back right there was leading the nation in rushing, and we held him to 50 yards.
Yeah, Max Mickey.
And the quarterback was second in the nation in yards per carry, and we held him to 23 yards rushing. So it was a huge day for our defense, and that's really what kept us in the football game.
So now 17-14 after that touchdown from Sioux Falls. Bisons now trail.
Right. And as I said earlier, we continued to move the ball. We just couldn't get a drive sustained, and it was, you know, really frustrating.
Terrence Dingle was huge for the Bisons also.
Man, Terrence Dingle was probably the story of that game to me in the way that he was able to come in a cold environment, hadn't played the whole day, and help us get untracked.
And Sioux Falls has momentum after the turnover right here as we move into the fourth quarter and the lead.
Right, they have the lead right here, and then they've got the ball and they're driving and you know, at one point with 10 minutes left to go, it didn't look too good for the Bisons.
Yeah.
But tribute to our guys, they never gave up.
He's going to run the football. He runs it forward. He is nailed. I mean, in the fourth quarter, down three.
Down 3-17-14 right here, and here's a big play.
That was a double move. They did a great job of executing it in our corner bid on the play, and they were able to get a touchdown to go up 10 points. And this is where we were saying, man, it looks tough. Here's Terrence. That was a very important play in the game. That was a fourth down and three. And you know, Terrence did a great job of running the option. Here he is again on the second phase. Getting the ball close to the 40-yard line. Beautiful job right there under pressure. He throws it up for Andrew, who does a great job in those kind of battle-for-the-ball situations. Comes back, runs a toss play to Zach Shelley. I thought Zach got in, but Park's able to come back in and run on fourth down, run the midline, or the follow play, the quarterback ISO, and we're able to get within three.
And that would prove huge to be able to get to within three.
Without a doubt. You know, this was our defense had to get us a stop. You know, we knew we probably would not have a chance to win if we didn't get a stop. And those guys rose up to the occasion in a great way. Look at that play in the backfield against their quarterback. We got guys all over him.
Out of timeouts,
force a punt. And we're able to use our two-minute offense that we had not used all year long, had not had a need for it, actually. And I was so proud of our coaches, so proud of our players. It was a beautiful pass right there by Park. We still kept the option game going. And you can see right there, that was a huge play to get us almost to the 40-yard line. And, you know, we know we're getting close. We run. That's actually a reverse pass. And we thought that the receiver was going to break open, but you know, Andrew felt better about the keep. And then we throw the quick screen to Grant in the flat, and he's able to get us a little bit of yardage. And we come back out, and boy, we force that one a little bit. But there's the kick.
We'll never forget.
47 yards by Tristan Parsley to extend the game and put us into overtime. Yeah, what a deal.
Wow. Yeah. So overtime, as the Bisons win the football game in overtime, and we're gonna see highlights from that as well after the Bisons do that. But Coach, before we go to the overtime highlights, that last drive, 57 seconds, that's all that was on the clock
right
when the Bisons got the football back and no timeouts deep inside the 20-yard line to start the drive.
And that's what I was talking about when I said I was so proud of our coaches and our players, because there was no panic. And you know, we knew we were under the gun, but we were able to execute that offense that we'd practiced all year long. Coach Luke Cullins did a tremendous job in the box of getting us in the right plays, and Coach Kenny Wheaton, obviously, we comboed the two-minute offense with a little bit of option, which kept them honest, and we're able to get the ball close enough for us to attempt that field goal. And it wasn't ideal conditions to kick a 47-yard field goal, but so proud of Tristan and that entire field goal team, the way they executed in a critical situation.
Yeah, good snap, good hold, took everything.
Absolutely.
Now let's look at the overtime highlights. This is very exciting as we go to overtime in the playoffs, and very important to win the toss.
And, you know, these guys have done a great job winning the toss all year long. We have pretty much been able to do exactly what we wanted to do in every football game, and we get to play defense first, and they start with a little pass and get the ball inside the 20, and kind of got us on our heels, and Benjamin Shields reads the quarterback's eyes in a tremendous way, makes a huge play, and we get the ball back and know that we're just going to try to manage the clock and get us in a position where we can attempt a short field goal. There's the midline again, and we got the ball down to the 17-yard line. And here's the field goal team again. And the Bisons win. What a tremendous win for our football team on the road against a 12-0 team, undefeated Northern Sun champions. And we're able to win that football game 27-24. And so proud of our coaches, so proud of our team for the way that we executed in that game under some difficult circumstances.
And the Bisons now 13-0 after that victory. But the two kicks, the 47-yarder obviously to tie it, and then the 35-yarder to win it, everything had to go perfect. The blocks were great up front.
Right.
Talk about the snap, though. I mean, we oftentimes do not talk about the long snapper unless it's a bad snap.
We don't talk about the long snapper. We don't talk about the holder.
Right.
And John Kane is a true freshman long snapper for us. And what a tremendous job John did all year long. He had very few what we would consider to be bad snaps. And Cole Blickenstaff, what a job he did in his second full-time holding. And you know, he was able to get that ball placed for Tristan both times. And Tristan really came through for his brothers.
So the Bisons in overtime with a victory 13-0 at this point. It would be one more trip up to Maryville, Missouri, and the Bisons would take on Northwest Missouri after the victory in Sioux Falls. Stay with us. We'll come back and look at those highlights right after this.
Looks like it's done.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckabee. The Bisons 13-0, and the trip up to Maryville, Missouri, cold afternoon, and a team that's used to winning. They won 5 national championships recently.
Quick,
won 2 of the last 3, and a great atmosphere for football.
Great atmosphere, and what an outstanding football team to get to challenge yourself against. And, you know, they took the opening drive and took it down and scored, and, you know, that's a statement made by that football team that they're, you know, they've made many times in the last several years. It was a great job of pressure by our guys and hanging in there. And obviously, he had to hold the ball because of the coverage downfield. You know, one thing about this football game is that our defense forced them into 5 field goal attempts.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Now, they have an All-American kicker. I mean, they have a tremendous kicker. But for us to force them into field goals when they're used to scoring touchdowns was a tribute to the way we played on defense. Our defense, I said it in the postgame interview, they were fantastic because we couldn't get anything going on offense in order to help them. We couldn't get them off the field, and it was really a tough day for us offensively. But our defense just kept going to work and battling and staying in there and not giving up. And that's a tribute to Coach Simmons, our defensive coaches, and our defensive players and the way they played. That was a great job of hustling right there by our guys on the delay. You know, this is an outstanding football team in the green. And as I said earlier, I think I said this, they've won 27 games in a row, and you can understand why. And, you know, they're undefeated in the playoffs the last 2 years and have been dominant.
Yeah, Zimmerman had only been sacked 9 times. Bison's able to sack him twice
right in
the game on Saturday.
Look at how tough we're playing on the goal line. That was such a tribute to our defense. I'm so proud of them.
Corey Bassett again right there.
Yeah, Corey had a tremendous year for us on special teams.
Scott Middleton had a big day.
Scott has played so solid for us all year long, and that's one reason, you know, Scott was recognized as all super region for us, and rightfully so.
Scott Middleton had 7 tackles in this game. Dalen Markham had 11 tackles in this game.
This was one of the big plays in the game. That was a huge play by Christian Witt. A great sack, knocked the ball loose. And that was right after that play that, you know, we thought we'd already gotten a fumble.
Now, coming out here in the third quarter, Bisons get a little something going here.
We do. You know, we get the reverse. And watch this great block by Eric Mitchell right there. And that's Corey Bassett. And we know how fast Corey is. In fact, I thought right there he had a chance to break that thing. But, again, their defense rose up. And, I mean, they are so good on defense. You know, just one of the most out. We have an outstanding defense. They have an outstanding defense, too. And they were able to keep us out of the end zone and got the shutout.
Christian Witt pursuing the football there.
Continued fantastic support by our guys.
Your football team played physical all season long.
They are a physical group of men, really. You know, they play the game the way it's supposed to be played, without a doubt. Mm-hmm. Great job by Trayvon. You can see the ease with which he beats his man. He's not able to finish the sack, but the pressure causes a throw, and then there's that field goal kicker again. He was very impressive the other day. This is the option pitch to Eric Simmons. And, you know, the 6 and 7 yard gains were few and far between. And, you know, those guys are, you know, they do a great job of flying to the football. They're a long defensive football team with a lot of speed. And you can't turn the ball over against them. They just continue to put pressure on you. There was Deontay with his pick. And fortunately for us, we were able to come away with that fumble. And Dalen Skidmore with another fumble recovery.
So moving to the fourth quarter, and Northwest Missouri State driving again, but the Bisons would not quit. Trayvon Biglow, what a play there.
Yeah, another tackle for a loss by Trayvon. And that, you know, that's just the story of the year for him, and he was dominant against everybody that we played, including the best team in the country. That was a great job by their guy. I mean, he pretty much came from the inside out and picked that ball off. And of course, that, you know, put our defense in a tough spot. You know, the 2 late turnovers on our end of the field were you know, tough as far as the position it put our defense in.
Season ends at 13-1, but what a season. I know this was a tough moment. I was there, obviously, on the Saturday and with the seniors.
Right.
Go by and tell everybody goodbye. But what a great right. season. And I thought you had a great message for them after the game.
Well, you know, it was important to me that I communicated to them that one loss, even, you know, only one team. If you get the playoffs, only
right.
one team's going to end up happy. And I just wanted them to know that we're not going to let that loss define our season. And still the joy that we had built throughout the course of that season. You know, when you are able to step away from it like we've been able to in the last few days and look at the body of our work during the course of the year, to win 13 football games, to set records that, you know, we broke a new ground for the Harding University football program. And I'm so proud of the young men on our football team and the way they represent us, because they are very deserving to be those guys that have broken that new ground. And I'm so proud of them.
Corey Bassett and Daylon Skidmore had a chance to catch up with them after the game and get their comments.
It's amazing. You know, I've been with these guys for 5 years, and it's a great senior class. Coach Huck gave me an opportunity a lot of people wouldn't. So, I mean, it's been an awesome ride. It has. You know, the most thing I'm just miss is playing ball, being with the players, being with teammates. And then, you know, Coach Huck, obviously. But it's been awesome. It really has.
Both of them, Daly, you can start. Talk about Coach Huck. I mean, he's on his way out today. This is his final game. Talk about how you're feeling about today.
Well, you know, I love Coach Huck, and I miss playing for you, Coach, a lot. And just couldn't take it all the way this year. And, you know, that last game today was a lot of fun. I think we left it all out there and did what we could. So I think we can walk off that field with our heads held up high. Just like Coach Huck said, that was a great football team, and I'm just honored to have played under you, Coach, and I'm going to miss playing for you. I'm going to miss playing with my brothers, and, you know, it's a family. We're going to have that bond forever. So, you know, we may have lost this game today, but, you know, it was a great season, and we made history, and we could have taken a little bit further, but, you know, we got to hold our heads up high and, you know, very blessed football team this year.
What a great moment there. Corey Bassett right before that, someone that – well, I had to go and search him out afterwards. Corey means a lot to me, and Daylon Skidmore as well. But those words from Skidmore about you, I know that had to mean
sweet,
a lot to you.
Sweet words, and, you know, love those guys so much, and they've meant so much to me, and they've been a blessing to me, and they've been an inspiration to me. You know, there's some young men on this football team that are as good a young man as you would ever choose to be around. The way they conduct their lives off the field, the influence that they have, the service hearts that they have. And for me to be able to spend my time with them and that to be my last senior class and my last football team has just been a wonderful blessing.
So we have one more break on the show. Right now we're going to take that, and then we'll come back and we have a couple of Bison seniors that we want to hear from after this timeout.
I wish I was in school.
If only I had a math test today.
I'll stay after class.
I'll clean the chalkboard.
I wish I was in school.
School ends, but free lunches for your kids don't have to. Find your local food bank at feedingamerica.org/summermeals for help.
Welcome back to Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. Now it's time to catch up with a couple of Bison seniors, Cordell Zielinski and Trayvon Bigelow. Now the Sioux Falls win, a victory that will live on way beyond all of us, and they'll be talking about it for many years. But a lot of people may not realize you were on the field goal unit. Obviously, everyone knows that you play defensive end. Talk about the 47-yard field goal and then finally the one to win it.
Yeah, well, at first, you know, whenever they did score, in my head, all I was thinking was, let's make a memory. Because, I mean, it's kind of that last-minute desperation. But, yeah, so when I took the field, I kind of joke about it. I had so much confidence in it because, in my head, it was an easy chip shot. I did not realize on the field that it was a 47-yarder. The only thing that was going through my head was don't let the guy through. And funny thing, like, Coach made the snap delayed, so trying to get him off sides, but they didn't go. And I was actually a little late getting to my spot. My guy kind of squeaked through the gap, and I was just trying to hold on. And in my head, I knew we were going to make it. We just had to keep them from getting in. I didn't realize how far a kick it was. And so I see it going up, and, you know, I put one hand up when I see whenever he gets it off, just already confident. And then whenever it finally goes through, I just put both hands up and walk off the side, and I see the whole sideline going crazy. I'm just like, man, these guys are – that was a given, wasn't it? And so I was kind of confused there, and I Like, I wanted to save my energy for overtime. But then I get on the plane and someone's like, yeah, this is 11 yards and it's longest kick and stuff like that. I was like, oh, okay. I went out there with way too much confidence. But no, I had a lot of confidence in Tristan. And I mean, he was nervous as steel, wasn't talking to anybody. And I was just, you know, it's funny. I told the team that day, the field goal unit, when we were practicing during warm-ups, I said, eventually this unit's going to win us a game. And it turned out to be that game. So that's pretty neat and pretty special.
Now you graduate in December. What's next for Cordell Zielinski?
So I'll be headed up to Bentonville, Arkansas, working for Walmart and their accounting and finance development program. It's a program last 2 years. You'll do four different jobs over the course of 6 months. And so a lot of opportunity there. There's been some old Bisons, Alex Finley, Aiden Minkin, Joe Calvin that went through the program. And so it's kind of like you got a little brotherhood up there too, but it's just a real special opportunity. It's another challenge. You know, Walmart's the biggest company in the world, and so I love that competition, that challenge mindset, and just being on one of the best teams. So I'm training a great team for another great team, but I don't think the Harding Bisons will ever be able to get rid of me. So
lastly, the last question, really a two-part question. You mentioned the brotherhood. What does that mean to you? And then finally, what does it mean? What is Coach Huckeby playing for him meant to you?
I mean, the brotherhood means so much to me, as in it's just, I always know I got guys that have my back and corner, and we always have like this special bond that no one's really gonna be able to share with us. I think of all the times we watch film together after games, that's usually some of the funnest times, where we're making fun of each other, or coaches getting on to us for messing up. And I mean, especially with the defensive line, we just have a lot of inside jokes that we say with each other and stuff like that. But the brotherhood as a whole, I mean, it's nice to know that no matter where we're at, I can always just pick up the phone and call someone that I had this relationship with. You know, we've gone through all these trials, the 7-4 season, which is a really tough season, and then come back to this 13-1 season. So it's been very great. And then Coach Huck means the world to me. A lot of stories of Coach Huck. Love Coach Huck. Definitely what I'm going to be taking away is just what he's taught me. And he got me to the point where I am today with the stuff that he told the team and how he wanted his team to be, such as like no entitlement or the IWPWE, the I Will Persist Without Exception, probably one of the things I'll take with me throughout the rest of my life, and then the Honor God, and then Coach Simmons with the Code Black. But just kind of that culture that Coach Huck made just shows me how important that leadership is and what a great culture can truly do. And so he's definitely been a father figure to me, and just being able to take all those lessons throughout the rest of my life and apply them to anything. So I'm taking my CPA test now, and a lot of IWPWE is going along with that. So just it's amazing how well football can translate to life, and Coach Huck's definitely helped with that.
This is not a routine season. This was one that will be talked about forever.
Honestly, early. After the first two games, you know, how efficient our offense was playing and how dominant our defense was playing, I remember talking to Deontay Garrett, who's a fellow D lineman. I was like, man, this feels like we're living a dream. Something about it, just it feels so unreal. And you know, what do you know? We went to the third round of the playoffs, and we finished an unbelievable season, broke a lot of barriers in the Harding football realm, and you know, it was amazing, and it all panned out that way. So
this defensive line so deep, mm-hmm. and you guys pushed each other each day, did you not? I mean, when you're talking about up and down, this was a lot of experience, a lot mm-hmm. of senior experience. There was quite a competition during the week.
Yeah,
how much did that help this football team?
It was competitive since day one. Since my first day as a freshman, we all just competed up until the very last bell, up until Northwest Missouri. You know, we pushed each other on and off the field with grades. We made sure that we all, you know, stayed above eligibility. We weren't just trying to be eligible. We were trying to make sure that we all set each other up for life. And you know, we always pushed each other with health, with film study, stuff like that. I mean, it was just competitive up until day one, and it all made us into the D-line that you see on Saturdays and the men that you talk to on a day-to-day basis. Basically, that's what we strive for, just, you know, making sure that we weren't caught napping, you know, we weren't caught just being okay, being average. So, it's just everyday battle.
And a very mature football team. Mm-hmm. Two games in the fourth quarter that really stick out to me, the Ouachita game, mm-hmm. come back to win it in the fourth quarter, and also, obviously, the Sioux Falls game. Yeah. What do you take from those two games?
What Coach Huck preaches, IWPWE, you know, I will persist without exception. And that's definitely what happened. Anytime we were down ever this season, you know, even last game, we never thought we were out of it until it was all said and done, you know what I'm saying? Just because that's the type of attitude we are. we have. You know, no matter what the score, no matter what the circumstance, no matter if we have a bunch of players hurt, regardless of what's going on, we're going to fight. And we're going to keep fighting until we hear that last whistle.
And talk to all the seniors. We would love to have caught up with more of them.
Right.
But with the season over, and obviously they're finishing up with classes. That's a great senior class and two great ones right there. And
you picked two really good ones to talk to. Now, there are a bunch more you could have talked to,
sure,
as you said. But, you know, those guys have no intention of being average. Those guys intend to dominate life. And they're going to dominate life with the right perspective, through the lens of their faith and honoring God and continuing to persist and all the things that have made our football culture what it is. And I'm so proud of them. And, you know, if I start talking about my seniors, I could go on for hours about each one of them. But so proud of the way they led and represented this program this year.
And Trayvon Bigelow, we found out, All-American.
Yeah, AFCA All-American, which is very well-deserved. He was dominant all year long in every single football game. Very rarely was he blocked, and he deserved that recognition for sure.
And I don't think we can finish the last show without talking about Park Parrish. I think someone that will be talked about in this program for many years. What a great competitor, what a great young man.
What a great warrior. And, you know, I love Park's answer when somebody would say, man, Park, what a warrior. You know, you keep coming back, and his answer is always,
yeah,
we got a team full of those guys, and he's exactly right. And Park was such a pleasure to coach, such an unbelievable young man, such an unbelievable competitor, leader, example, the right spiritual bent, and you know, he understands what's really important, and he's going to have a big impact on the world, like a whole bunch of these guys are.
Coach, what a legacy you left. You gave me this to wear several years ago, and the guys talked about that. No entitlement on there. Honor God and the IWPWI. That means a lot to me. I've worn it on every one of the shows to every game, and that's quite a legacy.
I appreciate you buying into that, because that's what we believe in. And, you know, first and foremost, honoring God. And the results that we had this year were 100% because of the fact that this is a blessed brotherhood, and you've heard me say that many times, and the fact that we worked really hard, we persisted, we didn't believe in entitlement, and because of all those things, we're able to translate that into success on the field. But in every game that we won, we prayed after the game, we would pray before the next game, that God would be honored by the things that we were doing. And I'm so proud of the men in this program, because I believe that to be true.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet,
My
buddy.
My pleasure.
You bet.
That wraps it up for our final show this season, as our final show with Harding Football with Ronnie Huckeba. We have a lot of highlights that we'd love for you to see. Tim Hamilton's worked hard on this, and we appreciate all the work with Tim Hamilton, Sham Rasselm, and Mark Pryor throughout the season. We'll see you next time.
Begin the second half. Bisons will get it to begin play in the second half. They'll be going into the wind. Bassett from the goal line. Across the 10. Bassett, the 20, 25, 30. Corey Bassett hits to the 40, and he's gone. 35-30. Corey Bassett to the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Harding. And we'll see how they officially score.
They may have to stay with us every week.
Yeah.
Here's Miller. Rolling right. Miller is sacked. They got.
The Bisons get it. And here is Parrish going to keep. Parrish 25-20 to the left side of the 10 to the 5. Park Parrish.
Dingle takes, drops. He's going to throw it on first down. Throwing right side. It is complete at the 5-yard line. And now play fake. He looks. He fires. Intercepted. Benjamin Shields intercepted it at the 15.
He field before the game. This is third down and 11. And now to throw, pump fake. And now pressure is there. And down.
Open field is to the right, and now Miller takes pressure coming. Skidmore, get. And bruises heel over the weekend for this football team. Toss right side, Shelley, 45-40. Shelley to the 30, right sideline, 20. Turns it back inside of the 10 at the. In the game, he is the B-back, and now they'll take here, give it to Reeds, and Reeds running left side, midfield, Reeds to the 45, and he'll,
good snap, placement down, kick is on its way, the kick is
good!
It's good!
It's good!
Takes, drops straight back, pressure coming, and he is sacked. He lost the football. East Central's going to get. Dingle takes, now Dingle give it left side. Here's Gates, midfield, Gates 45-40, and Gates trying to drag someone with him. He does so inside the 35, down. He's back in the game. He's in motion. And now give it to Shelley, right side. 25-20. Center of the field. Now angling left. 10-5.
Complete at the 17-yard line. Now the football's loose. It's picked up by the Bisons at the 15-yard line. And Harding gets.
Blake. Parrish will give to Connor. Right side of the five. Cuts it inside. So Dingle tanks, and now Dingle drops. Penalty flags down. Maybe a free play. Fires. It is a wrestle for the football. Football game to the right side. Now run it to the right on the pitch to Shelley. To the 35-30. Shelley, 25, 20. Turns it inside. 10. Parsley waiting. Placement down. Kick is on its way. And the kick is...